Hi, my name is Ruth Hardy. This is my lesson for the MTC teacher.
Hi, I'm Lucy Hardy.
And I'm Morgan Hardy.
Great. So the message that I wanted to share with you guys today is kind of based off the third lesson of the missionary pamphlets, which is the gospel of Jesus Christ. And one of my favorite points is at the end, where they talk about enduring to the end. So I'd like to pose the question for you guys. What is enduring to the end?
I think it's continuing faithful in the gospel.
Yeah. You know, figuring out what you need to do to return to God and then keeping on, you know, not deterring from the path.
Right. Mm-hmm. So in the third pamphlet, there's this quote that I like. Lucy, could you read that? It's the first highlighted part.
Mm-hmm. These first principles and ordinances of the gospel are a pattern to follow throughout life. This lifelong commitment is often called enduring to the end.
Awesome. Thank you. So I really love that part where he says a pattern to follow. You know, because a lot of the steps that we take in the gospel, we think is just one-time steps. You know, baptism is a one-time thing. Receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost is a one-time thing. But enduring to the end is something, it's a continuous pattern, as he calls it. It's a pattern of righteousness. And so how do we create that pattern of righteousness? What do you guys think?
I mean, just doing what we've been taught to do every day. That includes like reading our scriptures, praying, keeping the commandments, repenting when we need to.
Yeah, I think forming righteous habits. So the small things that keep us on the path that we need to do every day, make that pattern of living a righteous life.
Yeah, great, thank you. There's a scripture that I really like in 3 Nephi chapter 15. And here Nephi is, it's actually Jesus Christ when he's visiting with the Nephites, and he's telling them about the law of Moses and how it was fulfilled through him, and he starts talking about the gospel of Jesus Christ, and he talks about ways that we can continue on. Morgan, could you read 9 and 10, please?
Behold, I am the law and the light. Look unto me and endure to the end, and you shall live. For unto him that endureth to the end will I give eternal life. Behold, I have given unto you the commandments, therefore keep my commandments. And this is the law and the prophets, for they truly testified of me.
Awesome. So what did you get from that scripture?
I think just the law, as it says, the law and the prophets, is all of the things we learn from the scriptures, is really for the purpose of helping us endure to the end.
Right. Thank you. And I think it's really poignant when he says, I have given unto you the commandments. Like it's a gift. And I think sometimes we think of the commandments as like something that prevents us from doing something or keeps us away from things. But the commandments, like he says, are something given of God. They're something very special. And I love, in Portuguese, the word for keep is guardar, which reminds me of the word to guard, which is protect. And when we protect those commandments, when we keep them sacred to us, they become something more special. They become something that really helps us endure. So in 2 Nephi 31:20, there's a really classic scripture that talks about this enduring and this keeping of the commandments. And here he says, wherefore you must press forward with a steadfastness in Christ, having a perfect brightness of hope and a love of God and of all men. Wherefore, if you shall press forward, feasting upon the words of Christ, and endure to the end, behold, thus saith the Father, you shall have eternal life. So I really liked what you guys talked about in like continuing forward with the little things, pressing forward with the steadfastness. And I love this part where he says, pressing forward with a steadfastness in Christ. So what do you guys think of when I say the word steadfastness?
I think of just being like really solid in what you believe, or what you stand for, just kind of like immovable, I guess. Not giving in, or not, you know, being swayed by any influence. Like, you're going to stick, right, in what you believe.
Mm-hmm. I think of, like, a really solid ship that's not blown by a stray by the waves, but it's like steadfast. I don't know why I think of a ship, but something that's just not swayed by outside influence.
Right. I love what you said, because that actually reminds me of a scripture in James. It's after James 1:7, I believe. Find it here. 1:6, and he says, "But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering, for he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed." Mm-hmm. And so I think that when we are steadfast in our faith, like you said, you know, there will be winds and there will be trials that try to rock us, but we will stay firm like a ship. And as I was thinking about it, I was kind of thinking of our life as kind of like when you're rolling in a tire. And then you were like on the side of time and rolled in it. Mm-hmm. Because the life keeps going on, and we've got ups and we've got downs, and it's just part of life, and it continues and it continues. And yeah, there's trials, and but as we do the little things, as we keep our balance through reading the scriptures, through saying our prayers, then that will continue, and the difficulties won't go away, but ultimately we'll be able to make it to where God wants us to make it. Mm-hmm. And we have his help. We know that. We know that when we pray, when we trust in him, when we ask for help, he's there to help us get up. He's there to help us continue when it seems like we can't. So I'd like to invite you both, you know, in this whole process of enduring to the end, just to reflect tonight or maybe tomorrow on ways that you can better support yourself, ways to better keep yourself firm for when the trials or temptations come, to not be swayed by those and to continue to endure. You guys ponder that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Great. I just like to testify that I know these things are true. I know that enduring is not easy, but it is possible through the gentleness of Jesus Christ. And I know that he loves us and he's always there for us. I say these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Yeah.